Welcome back to my stand-up channel. Eminem's ex-wife Kim Scott, hospitalized after suicide attempt, years after he apologized for causing her pain over raps about killing her. Eminem's ex-wife Kim Scott was hospitalized following a suicide attempt on July 30, reports TMZ. Police and emergency workers are said to have responded to a call of a suicidal person at 46-year-old Kim's Michigan home. With Kim restrained by deputies due to being so combative and violent that medics were unable to assess her. Kim and Eminem, real name Marshall Mathers III, 48, share biological daughter Haley Jade, 25. Eminem also adopted Kim's daughter Whitney, 18, from a previous relationship, and Kim's late twin sister Dawn's daughter Elena, 27. The website reports when help arrived, Kim was cut, with several small lacerations on the back of her leg. It was claimed Kim was taken to hospital to undergo a medical and psychological evaluation, but is now at home recovering. Kim and Eminem married in 1999, only to proceed with a nasty divorce 2 years later during their famously stormy romance. They remarried in January 2006 but had broken up again by April. Their relationship and Eminem's rise to global fame inspired his hit movie, 8 Mile. Eminem and Kim's volatile relationship is one of rap music folklore. The controversial rapper has frequently taken verbal shots at his on-off lover during his recording career, rapping about killing her drug use and infidelity. In 1989, when she was 13 and running away from home, Kim and sister Dawn met a then 15-year-old Eminem, and the sisters promptly moved into his mom's trailer park with him as his foster sisters. 6 years later, Haley, who, along with her mother, is the subject of many of the singer's greatest hits, was born. In 1997, track Bonnie and Clyde from the Slim Shady LP. Eminem rapped about taking his daughter on a ride along to dump his wife's body in a lake. In track Kim, which appears on 2000 album The Marshall Mathers LP, and written while the pair were having marital problems 2 years previously, the star rapped about killing Kim and putting her in the trunk of his car. In 2000, after the track's release, Kim took Eminem to court to try to stop him from rapping about her anymore, and sought $10 million in compensation for the intentional infliction of emotional distress. She also sought to prevent her then estranged husband from having even partial custody of Haley, then 4. The pair later reached a settlement in the case and agreed to joint legal custody of Haley. However, just 2 years later, the Grammy winner took a shot at Kim's drugs arrest on track, Till I Collapse, from album The Eminem Show. He said, "My thoughts are sporadic, I act like I'm an addict. I rap like I'm addicted to smack like I'm Kim Mathers." His feelings mellowed in 2010 with recovery album track, I'm Going Through Changes, with the star rapping to their children, "I still love your mother, that'll never change, think about her every day, we just could never get it together, hey, wish there was a better way for me to say it, but I swear on everything, I'd do anything for her on any day." The remorse continued onto 2017's critically acclaimed album Revival, where Eminem finally apologized to Kim on track Bad Husband. He said, "But I'm sorry, Kim. More than you could ever comprehend. Leaving you was f**k harder than sawing off a f**k body limb." Kim has previously spoken of how she and the Stan hitmaker repaired their bond and became a best friends, saying in 2015, "He's been real supportive," she says. "We're really close. We're just trying to raise our kids together and make it as normal for them as possible." In 2016, Kim admitted that her single car crash on an empty road near her home in October the previous year was in fact an attempt to end her own life. "It was intentional," Kim told Detroit's Channel 995 radio show Mojo in the Morning. "I never expected to make it out alive," she said, adding that she had been clean for 10 years. An emotional Kim added, people think, just because we have money, that it makes us happy. Yeah, I can pay bills. Yeah, I can get my kids whatever they ask for and it's great to see them happy. But you lose friends, you lose family, you have no one you can trust you can speak to, she said. Witnesses saw Kim drive her black Escalade into a ditch, where it smashed into a pole and flipped upside down with her trapped inside. I sat at the end of a road where I knew that no one else but myself would get hurt. Yes, I drank, yes, I took pills and I hit the gas and aimed for a pole. Just months later, in January 2016, Kim's twin sister Dawn Scott was found dead in the Motor City trailer park after a heroin overdose. She was said to be estranged from Kim at the time of her death. Source: dailymail.co.uk. Please like, share and subscribe. Thank you for watching.